Listening Library presents Magic Treehouse Book Number 34, Late Lunch with Llamas. This is Mary Pope Osborne. Chapter 1, Not So Simple. The late morning air smelled of honeysuckle. Wind chimes jingled in the summer breeze. Jack sat on the front porch. He was reading a book about whales. The screen door opened.
"Hey," said Jack's sister Annie.
"Hey," said Jack.
"Guess what?
We're going on a picnic at the lake with Mom and Dad," said Annie.
"Great, I'm starving," said Jack.
He didn't look up from his book.
"Me too. We're having tomato sandwiches and potato salad," said Annie.
"Cool," said Jack.
"Yikes, look," said Annie. "A giant bird."
"Funny,"
Jack kept reading.
"Seriously, super big," shouted Annie. "Look, look."
Jack was sure Annie was kidding, but he couldn't help himself. He looked up at the sky.
"Whoa," he said.
An enormous black and white bird was circling above the house. It had a wingspan of at least 10 feet.
"I don't believe it," cried Jack.
He jumped up from his chair.
"It's a condor."
"What's that?" asked Annie.
"The world's biggest vulture," said Jack.
"Condors survive by eating mostly dead animals. Sometimes they hunt small living ones."
"Oh, that's sad," said Annie.
"No, it's nature," said Jack.
"Condors are amazing, but they don't live in Pennsylvania. How did it get here?" The condor flapped its wings and rose higher into the sky. It curved and glided toward the Frog Creek woods.
"It's a sign," said Annie.
"Come on," said Jack. He grabbed his backpack.
"Mom, Dad, we're going to the woods," Annie called through the screen door.
"We'll be back in time for the picnic," yelled Jack.
He and Annie hurried off the porch. They crossed their yard and ran down the sidewalk.
"There it is," said Annie, pointing.
The condor was soaring above the trees. It vanished behind the treetops.
"Go, go," yelled Jack.
Jack and Annie ran down their sidewalk and dashed into the Frog Creek woods. Sunlight streamed between the trees. Jack and Annie ran through shadows and light until they came to the tallest oak. In the branches at the top of the oak was the magic treehouse.
"Yay," said Annie.
"Where's the condor?" asked Jack.
"Maybe we can see it from up there," said Annie.
She and Jack scrambled up the rope ladder and into the treehouse. A book lay on the floor in a pool of sunlight. Jack picked it up. On the cover was a photo of tree-covered mountains rising above white clouds.
"Wow, beautiful," said Annie.
She read the title of the book,
"Travel Guide, The Andes Mountains of Peru."
"Andes Mountains?" said Jack. "I've always wanted to go there."
"Me too," said Annie. "Uncle Josh went there, remember? To Machu Picchu."
She opened the cover of the travel guide. A folded piece of parchment fell to the floor. Annie picked it up.
"A note from Morgan," she said.
She unfolded the note and read aloud.
"High on Old Mountain is a creature to save. Bring back the small one. Find the secret of brave. When faced with great danger, old legends will help you. Words from your book will give you a clue."
Annie looked up.
"Okay," she said. "Ready?"
"Hold on," said Jack. "Is that all she wrote?"
"Yep," said Annie. "We go to Old Mountain. We save the small one. Old legends will help us. Short and simple."
"Not so simple," said Jack. "What is the small one? Plus, there are thousands of words in this book. How do we find the right clues? And what the heck is the secret of brave?"
Annie sighed.
"Let's answer one question at a time. We can't solve a problem until we know what it is."
"You sound like Mom," said Jack. "Okay, ready to go?"
"Ready for anything," said Annie.
Jack pointed at the mountains on the cover of the travel guide.
I wish we could go to the Andes Mountains in Peru, he said.
The wind started to blow. The treehouse started to spin. It spun faster and faster. Then everything was still. Absolutely still. Chapter 2. Young Mountain.
Birdsong filled a mountain forest. The air smelled of cedar, pine, and wood smoke.
Oh, wow, said Annie. I love our clothes.
She and Jack both wore bright red wool ponchos, brown cotton pants and shirts, leather sandals, and green knit caps with ear flaps and purple tassels.
Colorful, said Jack.
And warm, said Annie.
Their ponchos were heavy and hung down to their knees. Jack's backpack had turned into a woven cloth bag. It hung by a strap across his chest. Annie and Jack looked out the window.
Oh, wow, said Annie. It's really pretty here.
The treehouse had landed in a tall pine tree in a forest of pines, cedars, and trees with huge hanging pods. Mountains rose on the horizon. Feathery clouds floated below their peaks.
The Andes Mountains, said Jack.
He opened their travel guide to the first page. He read aloud.
The Andes are the longest mountain range in the world. They run from the top to the tip of South America, a distance of 4,350 miles. High in the Andes of Peru, tourists hike through cloud forests and mountain meadows.
Cloud forests and mountain meadows, repeated Annie. That sounds beautiful.
Jack turned the pages. He stopped at a photo of men and women dressed in red ponchos and hats. The caption said,
Wool ponchos have been worn by natives of the Andes for many centuries.
Many centuries, said Jack.
So what century is this?
I don't know, but I have a feeling we came to a time long ago, said Annie.
Me too, said Jack, but I'm not sure why I feel that way.
Whoa, what's that sound? Said Annie.
What sound? Said Jack.
Music, hear it? Said Annie.
Jack listened carefully. Sweet, airy music floated through the cloud forest.
It's a flute, I think, Jack said.
Let's check it out, said Annie.
Jack put the travel guide into his bag. He followed Annie down the rope ladder. They stepped together into the tangled brush. The cloud forest buzzed with insect sounds. Hummingbirds and butterflies flitted among red and purple flowers. A pale green frog leapt over a tree root.
The flute music is coming from over there, said Annie.
Following the sound, Jack and Annie walked between the trees. They climbed over rocks and roots. They pushed through towering ferns. Soon they came to a clearing. They saw an elderly couple sitting outside a small hut.
We found the music, said Annie.
Shh, Jack whispered. Don't let them hear you.
The old man was sitting on the grass, playing a wooden flute. The woman was lifting potatoes out of a red-hot fire pit.
This feels like a long time ago, doesn't it? Whispered Annie.
Yeah, breathed Jack.
Look, llamas.
Oh, wow, whispered Annie.
In a small meadow behind the hut, several llamas were quietly grazing. They had woolly white coats, long necks, and camel-like faces. Their curved ears were shaped like bananas.
They're so cute, whispered Annie.
Jack had to agree. The llamas were cute.
I love llamas, whispered Annie.
Who doesn't? Said Jack.
No, I really love them, whispered Annie.
Why do people keep llamas? Jack wondered out loud.
Look it up, said Annie.
Jack pulled the Andes travel guide from his bag and searched in the index for llamas. When he found the right page, he and Annie read silently together. Llamas are the most important animal in the Andes. For centuries, they've provided mountain people with wool and carried their things. The Incas once believed llamas were protected by a star constellation.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.